As an add-on to my previous video about the BMP-3, I decided to also introduce you guys to the BMP-3's autoloader. And I'm not gonna talk about the basic autoloader, because it's not that significant and is basically the same as in the T-72. Instead, I'm going to introduce to you the BMP-3's ATGM autoloader. So hello and welcome and enjoy this video. In 1990 to 1991, the former Deputy Director General of Kurgan Mashzavod was developing a loading mechanism for the ATGMs of the BMP-3. A prototype was made, but it had some problems which kept it from being implemented in serial production of BMP-3s. Because, of course, most things don't work well right away. Nevertheless, he continued putting in the efforts to work on it. And eventually, it was implemented in the late 1990s as the ATGM autoloader for the BMP-3. It was first shown to the public in 1999 in Abu Dhabi as part of the BMP-3M modernization package, because nothing says welcome to the future like a weapon upgrade in arguably the most extravagant place on Earth. One of the main advantages of the autoloader was the fact that it was very easy to put into already existing turrets, and that the system didn't require any extra space or other major modifications, unlike trying to fit into your pants after the holidays. The autoloader could hold 3 missiles in a conveyor. The loading process was as simple as it should be, basically requiring the gunner to just press a button to start the loading cycle. The first missile in the conveyor is held by the loading mechanism, which includes a long tray with an integrated electric rammer. The motor for the rammer is at the end of the tray. The whole system is pretty efficient and only uses 2 electric motors for the loading process. One motor powers the rammer and pushes the missile into the 2 A70 cannon's breech in 2 strokes. This is most likely to save space. The second motor is located near the turret ceiling and pivots the loading tray into position behind the 2A70 and lowers it until it aligns with the cannon's bore axis. So if something goes wrong, why not have it happen right above your head? When loading, the autoloader elevator for the conventional rounds is raised to the turret roof and the 2A70 cannon is automatically elevated to a fixed angle. The loading mechanism then swings into alignment with the 2A70's axis using its electric motor. It lowers the loading tray into position behind the breech via a cam, and the integrated rammer pushes the missile into place. During this process, the missile conveyor shifts the remaining 2 missiles forward, like a really dysfunctional assembly line that somehow works better than your last Tinder date. Once the missile is loaded, the loading tray is raised back to its original position by the reverse drive of the motor and the mechanism swings back to the missile conveyor to latch onto the next missile. The following 2 videos show you everything I just said.
Механизм подает снаряд из магазина в орудие, он же выбрасывает гильзу после выстрела. На всякий случай, внутри машины есть запас дополнительных снарядов. Ими можно пополнить магазин, а можно перезаряжать вручную.
From what I know, there are no official numbers which tell the speed of the loading cycle, so let's just come up with our own numbers. Using the 2 videos I just showed you, it looks like the loading cycle takes 13 seconds to complete. Therefore, the maximum rate of fire would be 4 shots per minute. Only one missile can be flying at a time because the gunner's sight has a single guidance channel. And quite honestly, who would try to fire and aim 2 guided missiles at the same time? It's not a Hollywood action movie. Anyways, a second missile can be loaded right after the first one is fired. Considering the fact that the flight time of a 9M117 missile to its maximum distance of 5 km is just 16.8 seconds, the loading time is actually shorter than the flight time in long-range engagements. But to be real, a 5 km engagement range is just absurd, unless you're sniping from the Tora Bora Mountains to New York or something. At short to medium ranges, which are way more likely, the missile can reach its target in less than 13 seconds. In these cases, the autoloader doesn't allow the rate of fire to be no more than 4 rounds per minute, or 4 rounds in the first 52 seconds. With one missile already loaded in the 2A70, It is possible to fire 5 missiles in 1 minute at medium ranges, but to achieve this rate of fire, the infantry in the back would have to help reload the autoloader to fire 5 missiles, because the autoloader can only carry 3 at one time. So now, not only are you depending on a machine, but you also need to trust Private Murphy, who couldn't even tie his boots this morning. Good luck with that. Anyways, that was all I had to say for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you think I said anything that is not right, or you think I should have added any additional information to this video, please let me know in the comments and share your knowledge. Besides that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.